So the A300 emergency ventilator is a rugged, portable ventilator that leverages Woodward's capabilities in designing safety-critical systems for the aerospace industry and the energy and power industries. To develop the A300, Woodward and CSU collaborated on a process we call disciplined urgency. The idea here is twofold. First, we have to be very fast in order to provide a ventilator that provides for the humanitarian needs we see in the COVID crisis right now. We also wanted to ensure that we stay disciplined to our processes and that everything we did was safe to breathe for a patient.
Our approach was really to build on the 30-year history between Woodward and CSU working jointly to develop solutions for global energy challenges. At its most basic level, a ventilator needs to precisely shape the flow of air into and out of the lungs. Much of our work with Woodward over the years has involved shaping the flow of air and fuel into large industrial engines, such as the one that I'm sitting on here. So what we did was go into Woodward's portfolio of industrial control products to stitch together the components to build a ventilator that was able to use Woodward's supply chain and didn't rely on medical supply chains.
We have developed this product in a very short time. That means team members from Woodward and CSU in Colorado has put in long hours. And it's a global effort. We have teams from Europe and India also participating in this. In all, we had 24 hours a day work going on.
So our ventilator uses high-speed digital valve technology that we developed for metering natural gas on natural gas engines. These injectors are used on large 18-wheeler trucks. They live under the hood in very high temperature and high vibration environments and last for many years. For the exhale PEEP valve, we're using a precision rotary actuator that we developed for controlling air and fuel flow into natural gas engines as well. This component also is very ruggedized for use on engines, and it pinches a silicone tube in order to precisely control the exhale process. All these components are very durable. They're meant to live in high temperatures and high vibration environments. They're packaged inside of a very ruggedized case so that the whole unit can go into a truck, it can be stacked up to the ceiling, can go on rough roads into very remote regions all over the world.
The brains of the A300 are a ruggedized engine controller that was developed by Woodward for industrial applications. Woodward has a sophisticated set of software tools we've developed to control airflow into engines, gas turbines, and even aircraft engines. We can develop control strategies using these powerful tools, then download the executable code to the Aether controller. The human-machine interface is a ruggedized product that Woodward developed to control electronic generators, but has the functionality we need for setting the patient parameters and providing feedback to the medical team.
Woodward's forte is in developing complex engineered systems. At the heart of a complex engineered system is systems engineering, where we try to define and refine requirements and specifications. While the design team investigated hardware options in different configurations, the systems engineering team was looking to refine the parameters needed, such as respiration rate, tidal volume, peak inspiration pressure, positive and expiratory pressure, and fraction of inspired oxygen. After consulting with pulmonologists, respiratory therapists, medical school professors, bioengineering professors, respiratory technicians, the current operating modes that we decided on were volume control with pressure limits, pressure control with volume limits, and pressure support. We needed to be able to control breathing for a patient when they are incapacitated and yet be able to assist them to breathe when they are recovering, when they are able to take a patient-triggered breath.
The Aether product has the ability to be the most durable, full-featured ventilator. To ensure that it lives up to this potential, we've done extensive supportive analysis and accelerated durability testing. The inhalation valves were originally designed for use with natural gas, so to ensure their compatibility on oxygen, we performed accelerated durability testing here at CSU's Powerhouse Energy Campus and shaker table testing at Woodward's Lincoln Campus. We used computational fluid dynamics to support the design process and to ensure we didn't cause undue wear on any components.
Although Woodward has factories across the world, we don't develop any medical products currently. So when we took on the ventilator project, we had to leverage off of our core capabilities, which is designing safety-critical control systems for aerospace and energy markets. The Woodward facilities we plan on building the A3100 are all AS9100 certified. This is an aerospace standard that allows us to conform products, to control what goes into them, and to test them to ensure they're safe and reliable when they go to the customer.
We have consulted with a team of pulmonologists, respiratory therapists, to get the clinical background for the product. And then we've done testing with colleagues at the University of Colorado Anschutz Medical Campus to actually test the system. We have applied for emergency use authorization from the U.S. Food and Drug Administration and are now engaged with them on that review process. We submitted our system to the U.S. Army's COVID ventilator challenge, and out of the 200 entries, we were one of the five that were selected as winners. We received $100,000 from that competition and are now engaged with the Army on negotiation for a development and demonstration contract.
We are currently exploring applications of the ventilator in developing nations and for the Department of Defense. The Department of Defense is interested in having an insurance policy for a potential second wave of the virus, and in many of the developing world countries, they simply don't have the medical infrastructure we have in the U.S. I wanted to take a moment to thank CSU and all the different people across Woodward that helped out with this project, from people in Germany, Poland, India, and all across the U.S. We had many, many people come forward and work on this. We had a lot of long, hard hours. We worked weekends. And what I have to say is across the board, the teammates, whether they're at CSU or Woodward or at our supply base, everyone just pitched in with the common goal of doing something for humanity. And it was really heartwarming for me personally.